Hello, everybody. It is 4:36 p.m. Central Time on Friday, November 18th, 2016. And welcome into the Earthquake 3D live stream, where we daily recap the events that strike around the world. But we're not doing that right now. The point of this little update here is to get into the viewer mail that was sent again that filled up my P.O. box. And, I mean, it was full. So we've got two packages and two letters, and today got multiple letters and another package, and this one package is cylindrically shaped, and it's from Edmund Kratzer, hope I'm pronouncing your last name right, and he's been asking if I got it, so I have got it, so, you know, maybe now would be a good time to get into opening it up and showing everybody what's inside the boxes. I'm curious, are you guys curious? I sure am. Let me get the screen here centered. And let's just get right into it. So first things first, let's see. We've got one, two, three. We've got five letters. First letter is from Sunny out of Spring, Texas. Then we've got one from NEU. I guess that's new out of Batavia, Illinois. Can't make out the name on the return address here. Out of Vancouver, BC. Techahoppe, California, and Florence, Oregon. Then also the cylindrical package from Edmund, and that's coming out of Northampton, Pennsylvania. So let's get into that first, and then we'll get into the other two boxes. And I'm curious. I want to see what's in it, so this is unopened. I can't use the letter opener on this, guys. This actually has some tape and some other stuff. So this is taped up pretty good. I don't want to cut myself here. Let's just slightly cut it. Well, there we go. Okay. Oh, it's taped up even more on the inside. What is this? What the heck is this? Wow. Okay. Top is taped too. Wow. Okay. So it's some kind of plastic container here with duct tape around the top. I hope I'm not going to open this. It's going to be like ISIS, you know what I mean? Boom! Dutchsinse experiences his own seismic shock wave, all right? All right. Let's see what we've got here. Okay. What is the... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. A crystal ball! A crystal ball! Oh my god, he sent a crystal ball. Mecha-leka-hi, mecha-hiney-ho. Where is the earthquake going to come? Do we know? Well, we've got a letter in here, too. Oh, hello, it says, with a bunch of L's and O's. Michael Janich, Mr. Dutchsinse. Well, buddy, it's been about 7 years now since I found you. You've opened my eyes a little bit more than what they were already. Thanks to you, you have helped find and define for better words who I am today. Wow, that's huge. I thank you for that. I had just recently found your live stream through a friend on Facebook, William Barker, and I keep getting messages from him and finally clicked the link and found your stream. I'm glad I clicked it, too, because for the past 2 months, I have been able to put a theory together that involves my family and earthquakes. However, I need to write it down so I have a complete proof of it. LOL. Yeah, you need to do that. You definitely need to do that. Always write it down and poor man's patent it for yourself. Mail it to yourself and don't open it. Anyways, enclosed with this letter is a very special crystal ball for you. It was given to me about 15 years ago by my Nana, Lucille. And she said to me, then you will not know how to work it right away, but at some point you will know its purpose. So when the time comes, you will know what to do with this. I'm handing this down to you, my friend. Let the energy from this crystal ball to guide you in your failures. I know my Nana spent many hours giving this a lot of positive energy for you. It will also protect you from, well, you already know that, smiley face. Anyways, keep up the great work that you do. Whoops. You always say you're going to stop, but I know you have a big heart and will never stop doing what you love. Yeah, I do. I get burnout. I get burnout. It's like a job that you don't get really paid much for. You're like, I'm done with this. And then like the next day you're back. Oh, and by the way, remember back on April 4, 2014, I told you on the Freedom Frequency radio show that you should do a live radio weather show. Well, this is where you're supposed to be. It's not actually weather, but it's pretty freaking close. Again, just like when you, it comes forecasting and predicting, we do miss sometimes. By the way, Selena, 4 years old, and Mackenzie, 1 year old, say hi, Dutch. And hi, guys. Hi. Hi, Selena and Mackenzie. Selena. When Mackenzie hears your voice on the laptop, she waves, and I say, baby Dutch can't see you, silly, LOL. The wife says thank you as well. Much love from Pennsylvania, Edmund Kratzer. And from Selena, smiley face. Ah, she hand-drew the smiley face. Look at this. There's a hand, the kid smiley face down at the bottom. That's great. That is absolutely great. Well, the crystal ball is going to go right here next to the camera. You know what? Yeah, you should be able to see that there. Hopefully you will. Yeah, that goes right in front of my mouse. Oh, that is the best. That is the best. Now when they say I do earthquake prediction, you guys can say, yes, he does. And he puts on his turban and he says, Mekalek, Aini Ho, and all this other stuff. It's great. Okay. Score, brother. All right, let's do the other two packages in a minute, and let's get into the letters, because let's get into this first one. This comes from Techahapi, California, and I don't know if they want me to read their name on this, but I do know who this is, and thank you for the letter opener, by the way, guys. Howdy, Dutch. Mr. P here. Take a moment. Thank you for the nice letter you wrote to me, and thank you for your trust in me to help with your channel. Mr. P is one of our moderators, guys. Okay. I don't know if I should read this to you. This has to do with my channel and. We should definitely talk. A lot of stuff going on the back end of the channel between the moderators. Yeah. You know what? I should read this separately. This is going to be a private letter for me to read. That this is not, he's contacting me privately. So we will read that. We will address this later. There we go. Okay, we'll get into that one. Mr. Pink, thank you. Thank you for writing me. I will write you back on that. Okay, next one's coming out of Florence, Oregon, and it just says it's coming from Florence, Oregon, no name attached to the outside, so let's just, well, what am I doing? Why am I using a knife? I've got a letter opener right here. Sent to me by a viewer. Okay, Florence, Oregon. Okay, we got a card and a letter in here. Oh, a postcard, an unused postcard. Multnomah Falls, Columbia River, Oregon, view of the Multnomah Falls. Boy, I need a better light in here. There we go. That's pretty. That's really pretty. I love getting postcards from other states or other countries, guys. So if you've got postcards you want to send, please send them over. Okay, what's our letter here? Michael, this is a personal message, and I prefer that you not read it on the air. So that's how it starts out. Okay. I will address. This has a question in it about the Cascadia subduction zone. So, but it's a personal. It's a question they want responded to privately. I understand. That's cool. Because we're going to be discussing. It's a long story on that. Okay. All right. Kick. kick butt postcard right there, and that will be going into the collection, and I will respond to you. I will write an answer to your question since you don't want me to read that on air. Not a problem. Not a problem. It's addressing a few things that are controversial in geophysics, guys, quite frankly, and I understand. That's a big deal. Okay, so this comes out of, I think the name on here is Big Fan. Big Fan. I don't know if you see that. Big Fan up here at the top. I'm covering their return address. Big Fan. All right. 2020 vision on the back. 2020 vision for Dutch. It's got a heart and it says 2020 vision, Dutch 2020. That's my presidential campaign, guys, when I run. But first I got to release the book of all the scandals that I ever did, all the partying I did, and all the girls I ever knew. Before my wife, of course. All right, let's get in. Ooh, this is pretty. What do we have here? First of all, let's look at this. Look at what this is. It's a garden scene. It looks like Pacific Northwest. Looks hazy and misty, a little bit foggy. Let's see. Dear Dutch and Duchess. Oh, whoa, what's this? Taped on the inside. Hold on. You, Dutchsinse, are my main monkey. Don't let those bad baboons bring you down, dude. You're awesome. And it's got a monkey. Oh, wow. Whoa. We got some money in here, guys. This is foreign currency. Wow. Here, I don't want to tear it. It's taped on the inside. What is this foreign currency here? A Canadian 50 with some hearts, and look at the little monkey on there. Look at this little guy. Look at this. Canadian money, guys. Canadian money. Hey, Canadian money. Oh, your dollars are way better than ours. This is high quality. It's like plastic almost. Hear that? That's plastic. Wow. I've never actually had Canadian billage before. Okay, here is the message. Dear Dutch and Duchess, 10 years ago when I discovered my seismic bones, they are triggered painfully during quakes, I've attempted to track online sites to test this theory. Have noted the way the official sites screw up the data. So glad you popped up to bring integrity back to the field. Much gratitude, heart, and they gave me their email here. And this is... Newfoundland. This is a shot from Newfoundland. Wow. And 50 Canadian. I mean, you know what? That's going to go in my bug out bag. I'm going to keep it in the Canadian form. And this will go in the bug out bag in case, you know what, hits the fan and currency is worth nothing. At least I'll have 50 bucks to go. You know what I mean? Wow. Thank you. You'll be getting a thank you card back. Okay. Wow. Well, my viewers... You know, this is cool because now I got $5 Australian from another viewer. Look at this. Now, I mean, again, it's the currency, I mean, you know, it's so cool to get. I mean, I probably won't ever cash it in and use it as US dollars, so it's just something that's really cool to have, or if I really need it, it will come in handy. So this comes from NEU out of Batavia, Illinois. Okay. Well, let's try it this way. That's it. Thank you. Thank you for the generous check. I mean, my viewers, you guys, I mean, I understand some people don't like using PayPal. Thank you. Well, you'll be getting a thank you letter back. All right. Well, this is the last letter here. We'll get into the two packages just in a moment. Thank you very much from Joseph. No. Yeah. Joe. I guess that's your company. Okay. This comes out of Spring, Texas from Sunny. This is a a visa card. It's like my, I swear this is crazy. A small thanks for all that you do. All you do, Dutch. Thanks, Sonny. Thank you. Thank you. I mean, every bit will help. Every bit helps, especially since YouTube totally killed the live stream and made it so I don't make anything. And I mean nothing. So thank you. You guys, thank you. You will all be getting a thank you card. So, okay, well, that's the letters. There was not very much to read, as it turns out. So just one from Mr. P, who I need to read that separately. And the other I need to address with the questions, which I will write back. All right. Well, I mean, we've got two more boxes to open. Let's get into the smaller box first. This comes from Lori at 98021. What zip code is that? Let's go look that up. 98. Whoop. Nine. Oh, no wonder my number lock's not on. I'm like, why is my not Canadian numbers on there? Okay, 98021. Washington. Okay, Washington. Botel. And on the outside of the box, it says content. So it's got a content on the outside. I don't want to ruin it for anybody, though. So I will, it's telling me what's in it, so I know. So we can open it up. Okay. Anything else in here? I'm missing? Nope. Okay. We will put this off to the side so we can write you back. Okay, here we go. Got a letter on the top. Dear Dutch, thank you for sharing your talent with us. Thanks for persevering against all the obstacles thrown at you. Thanks for using your intelligence and curiosity. Keep learning more. You're a born teacher. To Mrs. Dutch, thanks for sharing Dutch with us. Your support is what helps him the very most. He wants to keep us safe, but he could not stay on an even keel without your ability to be a sounding board and muse. I have been making things since I was very young, but began selling crafts for a living 25 plus years ago when our daughter battled and beat bone cancer. Wow. Congratulations. That's good news to hear. The granddaughter I have running around at this moment is my joy and all that. So, anyways, when I heard Mrs. Dutch loves crafts, it really made it clear that I should send something I made. Thank you. That's very much appreciated. We really appreciate these kind of gifts. These woven star ornaments were born out of old craft that Scandinavian made of stars woven from basket materials. I experimented until I could make them from fabric. I printed a picture of the process on the back of this note. When I display this picture at my shows, people have a hard time believing I actually do this and still sell them. Have a wonderful and blessed holiday season. In the darkest times, please hold on to how much you are held in our esteem. Hang in there. Much love, Lori. And you give me your YouTube names. Okay, it's got a diagram of how she makes these. Okay, oh, whoa. There we go. And let's open the box and see what's inside the box. Oh, whoa. Whoa, these are really cool. These are very intricately made. Look at this. Look at that. And this is like a hard fabric-y type material, and they're red, and we've got a kind of a whitish snowflakey color. Special snowflakes. These are special snowflakes. Look at this. Really cool. Look at the knotwork on that. Wow. Well, these will get a special place on my tree this year, and I will get a picture and post it when we have the tree decorated. And let me save this little on the outside here. We'll fold that up and put that inside so we don't lose it. Wow. Cool. My viewers, man, I love your handmade stuff, guys. It shows that you're dedicated. It's just very thoughtful, too. on top of everything else. Thank you guys for being generous and sending donations, and thank you for being cool and making stuff. You know, that's just incredible. I'm not very crafty at all, so like I'm lucky to even put two sticks together. And that's no joke. Like, give me some popsicle sticks, and I might be able to make you a fence for a train set or something. Okay, well, here we go. So, this is the last box, and it says it comes from Hammacher Schlemmer out of Fairfield, Ohio. But I'm thinking Hammacher Schlemmer is a place you can order from. I've heard of the name, but I've never, you know, seen anything from them. So, let's see what's inside. It's kind of like an Amazon, I suppose. Okay, what do we got going on in here? Okay. What is this? Don't spoil your surprise. Open your gift before this envelope. Hammacher Schlemmer. Now, there's a couple packs of batteries in here. A couple 4C batteries and 4 double A's. And a box. This is all that's in there. Whoops. And a box that's gift wrapped. And what does it say on here? Hammacher Schlemmer. Established 1848. The best, the only, and the unexpected. Uh-oh. I don't want to tear this. The unexpected. Uh-oh. What is the unexpected? Whoa. Oh, I tore it. Okay. All right. Well, if you, I always try to save the paper, but what is this? No way. Hey. Wait, Errol. I'll tear it off and then you'll see it. This is really wrapped good. I mean, whoever did the wrapping on this is probably had a machine do it. Look at this. A Kit Kat clock. Have you guys ever seen one of these? This is, you put the, of course, the tail wags and the eyes move. And you see these actually in old cartoons. Smile with Kit Kat. Since the mid-1900s, the midst of the Great Depression, the Kit Kat clock has been inspiring hope and entertainment with his rolling eyes and wagging tail. The Kit Kat Kitty Cat clock continues to bring joy to millions. Today, Kit Kat is a character interesting in many of lives, many of the intrinsic philosophy of life. Now you can catch Kit Kat thoughts on t-shirts, beach towels, watches, and much more. Hi, I'm Kit Kat. Exciting news for you. Thousands of Kit Kat International Fan Club inviting you to come join us where we live. That's cool. You know what? I'm going to put this up on the wall. This is going to earn it. This has earned a place on the wall. It's going to be right behind me. You'll see it up here next to my Star Trek communicator that my wife got for me this past year. Yes, I've got a Star Trek communicator here. All right, Captain's log, Stardate supplemental. Oh, wow. Okay, well, this has been a tremendous little package opening for us here. Got a Kit Kat clock. Of course, thank you for the foreign currency, the Canadian 50. This is, I mean, it's, guys, Canadian 50 is worth 50 US. So, you know, we're right thereabouts. And it's really cool just to have it. So thank you for that. And thank you for the generous checks, guys. Also, to Mr. P, I will be responding to you privately. And Sonny, thank you for the gift card. And here we go. The letter I'm not supposed to read on air, but is definitely poignant, talking about subduction zones on the West Coast and Oregon. This comes from Jay. It's just signed Jay. I don't see any other name on it. Big fan Jay, I think. That's what it says. Or maybe it's in this card here. Nope, it's not in there either. Not a problem. You can stay anonymous. That's fine with me. You don't have to give up your identity if you're writing me. That's totally cool. All right. So, everybody, thank you for everything you sent. I do these unboxing videos as I get stuff accumulating in. So I don't do them every day, but lately there's been so much coming in since I started the P.O. Box that I'm literally doing unboxing videos almost every other day because there's literally that much stuff. Otherwise, it'll be a 2-hour long video unboxing if I let it pile up over the course of a week. So thank you, everybody, for being so generous. If you have books you want to send for me to read, I of course am always into reading new books. And if you guys have questions, you can send them to my P.O. box as well. So, all right, that was fun. I'm going to save this as a video on my channel so the people who did send stuff can come back and watch later. All in all, and how could I forget the most important